हेलो ट्रेडर्स, टुडे वी हैव विटनेस्ड अ शार्प फॉल आफ्टर 2 PM इन निफ्टी इंडेक्स एंड विच वॉज द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ द ट्रेडिंग रेंज इट वॉज प्लेइंग एंड द फेल्यूर ऑफ इट्स ब्रेकआउट विच आई हैव शेयर्ड ऑन आवर टेलीग्राम चैनल वेर वी हैव सी आई हैव शेयर्ड द ट्रेडिंग रेंज विच वॉज द पोटेंशियल लीड फॉर द अपकमिंग ब्रेकआउट बट on the latter part the breakout got failed and it have given a decent 160 point fall. Let's see what exactly happened in the This is what I am talking about. I have published this chart around 1 pm when the Nifty was trying to break its own highs over here. And I have already informed in the channel that if in either direction Nifty breaks its range, it will lead to the great move. But what exactly happened here? It have failed its this particular breakout on the upside and given a sharp fall on the downside. So let's learn about what exactly the breakout failure is and why this happens and how we can benefit from it. I have prepared a small PPT on it. Let's discuss this. On the breakout failure or the particular pattern, why it fails? It fails due to the imbalance between the buying and the selling pressure which we predicting as per the particular pattern. And when it fails, there may be several reasons of it. The first one, we can say the dominant group had limited scope, that is the buying a certain amount of asset and their capacity is we can say limited. In that case, though your analysis is correct, your theory is correct, but the pattern fails after the particular breakout. Second, the dominant group is surprised or overcome, which means though the bulls are trying to push the prices higher and higher, but the particular sellers or the bear group enters and they surprise the current trend and they shake the current trend and reverses it to the downward side. And there may be some other influences like the other news, any calamities or the any policy which were not expected or a particular such kind of news. And finally, I can say we misread the pattern or otherwise our fumbled in the analysis, that it might be our fault during the properly analyzing and forecasting the pattern. See what happens when the breakouts, we mostly look for the breakouts in the trading range. Let me change the color. We look for the breakouts from the trading range. When this breakout was attempted, we see the formation of new trend. Let me show you. If the prices are rising higher and they are consolidating in a particular range over here, at the time when the breakout happens, at this particular range when the breakout happens, it starts either in a continuation or in an opposite direction. So and that will give us a new trend, but these are our expectations. But most of the time what happens, the attempted breakout fails and it again comes back to the trading range. Let me draw you for this. Suppose the prices are moving higher and they are consolidating in this range. After breakout, they again come back to the range. So this might be one case. Second, the attempted breakout got succeeded and the new trend that may lead to the trading range. See, let me show you with some charts. The particular stock was moving in up direction and it was then consolidating in a range, and after breakout of above this level we are expecting the continuation of the trend. This is our expectation. But what happens when the breakout fails? You can see here, we were expecting it to go in this way, but at due to any reason which we have discussed in the previous slide, this breakout fails and it tries to come back to the earlier trading range. And this is what we say the failure of breakout and change of the trend. In this way, the price which was broken up, it first came to the range again, and then after range it again, due to the heavy selling pressure, it continues to the downward side. So is it a failure or the expectation? This is depend on your point of view, on which side you are looking for. We can say sometime this can be a failure, and many a time this can be a trend reversal. In this slide you can see, if it broke down and it started to move like this, then we can say the existing uptrend was halted here and now we are looking for the next downtrend. Before summarizing it, let me show you with the charts the theoretical concept which we seen from the slides. Here we have observed Nifty was trading in the range from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. 1:30 p.m. Then at 1:30 p.m. it's attempted the breakout on the upside. Retest happened, again tried to go up, but due to lack of bulls or the heavy sellers, it failed, and this breakout again pushed price to the range, and from there, due to heavy selling pressure, prices went down for another 120 points. So this is what happened in the today's market. And in such cases, while playing breakouts, our stop losses must be below the breakout candles. Suppose you have entered over here on this breakout candle, your stop loss must be here only. Otherwise, many have incurred a huge loss of this kind of fall. I hope you have learned something from today's PPT. Let me show you. Quickly view the summary. Failure can offer powerful trading opportunity. Yes. So don't take them negatively. Failures can be a good opportunity for the opposite directions trade. Here you can see when breakout happened, it have given you only 20 points, but the fall was of 150 points. So this can be a good opportunities for trading. The group, why this happens? The group of trapped traders may scramble to adjust positions and driving prices into the sharp and clean moves. But it is important that we adjust our own expectations, and we must follow the proper money management rules. You work on to develop the psychological skills to act decisively with the and with the flexibility that if breakout fails, you must cut out your losing positions and if possible take the opposite direction trades. Yeah, with this I'm signing off. If you learn something from this, just like, subscribe our channel and share it with your friends. Thank you.